Rolling Stone just published this incredibly frightening piece titled "The Fuse Has Been Blown and the Doomsday Glacier is Coming for Us All," which, yikes. It's about a huge glacier in the western Antarctic that's the size of the state of Florida. That glacier, known as Thwaites, is basically holding back enough ice to raise sea level around the world by 10 feet. A new study found that the ice shelf holding that ice in place could be gone in less than a decade. I'm going to quote for you from this new piece. If Thwaites Glacier collapses, it opens the door for the rest of the West Antarctic ice sheet to slide into the sea. Globally, 250 million people live within 3 feet of high tide lines. 10 feet of sea level rise would be world-bending catastrophe. Not only goodbye Miami, but goodbye to virtually every low-lying coastal city in the world. Jeff Goodall is the author of that piece for Rolling Stone, and he joins me now. Jeff, you've been a great climate reporter for many years. I've read your last book about flooding. And describe for me the finding here, because there's sort of a difference between like the shelf the glacier's on and the glacier. Is that right?
Yeah, there's been a lot of confusion about this. So what was recently been kind of revealed is that the ice shelf that works is like kind of like a fingernail that grows off the glacier itself and is floating in the ocean is cracking up. They've found some major fissures and fractures in that ice shelf. And one of the scientists in this recent study has suggested that that ice shelf could crack up within 5 years, which is a very big deal in itself. But that is not what's going to raise sea levels. The ice shelf is already floating. And so like ice cubes in a glass of water or something, when the ice cubes melt, it doesn't raise the water level. What the ice shelf does is work as a kind of buttress, kind of holding back of the glacier itself. And as you said in the intro, Thwaites is a giant glacier. It's the size of Florida. And once that buttress is gone, there's no telling how long it will take for that glacier to begin collapsing. And what's really important to note about Thwaites that's different than basically every other glacier in the world is that it's not melting like a popsicle on a sidewalk on a hot summer day, you know, because of warmer weather. It's melting because the changes in the ocean current temperature, just 1 or 2 degrees, that warmer water is getting underneath the ice shelf
right.
And underneath the glacier itself. And the concern is that by melting it from below, it will destabilize a lot of the glacier or most of the glacier, and the whole thing will crumble and fall into the sea, kind of like dumping a whole like bag of ice into the water at once. And that is a catastrophe.
Right. So you've got this ice shelf that is cracking. And that shelf, what's key about that is it's a key protector for the glacier. It's buffer zone, it's shield, the thing that stands between it and the water. And to the extent that that goes away, that reduces the protection the entire glacier has. And now it's being attacked, essentially, structurally, by warmer water. And the warmer water is being driven by climate change.
Exactly. Exactly. And what's important is that, I mean, there's many things that are important about this, but one of the things that's important is that, you know, it's a great example of how, you know, we talk about 1 degree of warming or 2 degrees of warming and what the changes that will bring to our world. And of course, we're already seeing them in places like Alaska, like you showed in your intro, and the wildfires in Colorado right now. But what Antarctica really shows is that even tiny changes, literally 1 degree of change in the water temperature, is enough to destabilize this entire ice sheet, which has huge consequences for our world.
Yeah, and it also speaks to the fact that it's happening. The most extreme places we're seeing, the most extreme manifestations of climate change we're seeing now are is in the North Pole and are in those places in the world, in the Arctic, where the changes are the most intense. But they have repercussions for all of us that don't live in the Arctic. I mean, that's the other obvious but fundamental thing to get your head around here.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of the really hard things to communicate about climate change and about why this crisis is so urgent is that it's not just, you know, that it's 70 degrees or 75 degrees today here in Texas where I am. It's not just what we see and feel in real time around us. It's these much larger changes that are happening to our world in places that are very remote from us, but have incredible consequences. I mean, when I was at Thwaites Glacier in a couple of years ago, I was there on a research vessel, and we went right up to the face of it. And it was this incredible moment of encountering this sort of, it felt like being on another planet. But it was also, I know from my work as a journalist, that what happens there has a direct impact on, you know, Miami Beach real estate and on the supply chains in Houston and on the risks of extreme storms and flooding on the Gulf Coast. So it's making these larger links that is what's so hard to bend your mind around the climate crisis and why it's so important to pay attention to this stuff.
Yeah, your last book is called The Water Will Come. Is that the last book?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love that book. I would recommend it to people. It's a really, really, really good book. We should just also note, you mentioned the wildfires. There are wildfires right now outside Boulder in December. I think there's 600 buildings that have been consumed, including, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, a hospital which has at least been evacuated or threatened by it. This is December wildfires, which is obviously unheard of and unnatural, and another indicator of how awry things have already gone and how much worse they will get if we don't do everything we can. Jeff Goodall, great reporting. Many thanks.
Thank you for having me, Chris.
So that does it for All In this year. I would just say, if you're about to go into this new year mourning someone that you lost this year, I wanted to offer my condolences and tell you that a lot of people are thinking about people they lost this year, people that got sick this year, hardships they went through. And I hope everyone can be as kind to each other as possible, show each other grace in this new year, and struggle together for a better world.